Hello there, I'm Hariharan Suresh, Senior Solutions Architect with AWS, helping customers to transform their businesses using machine learning. In this session, I'm going to walk you through how AWS can help to automate Know Your Customer process, in short, KYC. Let's get started. The agenda of this session is to demonstrate the ways to automate data extraction of identification cards, onboarding procedures, and use the KYC information for effective transaction monitoring. This session is primarily focused for developers who have not used machine learning before, helping them to use machine learning powered optical character recognition, face detection, and face comparison capabilities to their business applications. The KYC process starts with identifying and onboarding new or existing customers using their identification documents like passports, driving licenses. The captured KYC information can be used by organizations for workflows such as high-value bank transactions, compliance requirements, or even executing fraud checks. The end-to-end KYC processes may have additional steps based on the business requirements. You can use the solution and apply them to any industrial vertical. This KYC solution has two steps. The first step is to gather the customer data from the business-approved identity documents like passports or driving licenses. The face information in the identity documents is also extracted and indexed. The face extraction from the identity documents will be useful for verification purposes when executing any business transactions. In the second step, the extracted KYC data can be approved based on the automated data extractions confidence course. You can enable manual approval mechanisms in case of document extractions with lower confidence scores. If your processes needs any business-specific customizations, you can implement the logic before or after the approval process. So once completing the approval process, the transaction verification can be enabled for the downstream applications. Pre-KYC checks can also be established based on the organization's compliance policies and time limits for enforcing re-KYC. Let me walk you through a quick demo on what we will be achieving with this solution. I have built an application that captures the live feed of images from the client machine and prompts users to perform a challenge. This challenge triggers a series of verification processes, like there should be only one face captured, the face should be centered, nose should be moved to the target, with head rotation to figure out that I'm not showing static pictures for verification. I must move my nose to the randomly defined target position shown on the screen as yellow box. Let's revisit the steps mentioned and take a closer look. Once passing the challenge, the captured face will be compared using Amazon Machine Learning Image Analysis Service to get a match with the organization's face collection. If any of the challenge is not fulfilled, then the validation will not pass through. For example, if the face is out of the challenge area or the person is trying to fake the application by showing static photo, this will fail the challenge. On successful verification of the face, this information can be captured and used later for compliance or audit needs. A typical use case of this demo would be banks or financial institutions trying to validate their customers in real-time basis. Let's now take a look at the AWS services which aids in every step of this automation. It starts with optical character recognition for extracting data from PDF or image formatted documents. Next is to execute face detection and face comparison, which is showed during the previous demo. This solution is designed using a serverless model enabling pay-per-use pricing. I will walk you through the architecture explaining the aspects of the service put in use. The customer's identification cards or documents in PDF, image, or TIFF format will be uploaded into a durable storage service. The storage service then triggers an event notification when any new object is uploaded, kickstarting a serverless orchestration workflow for processing the uploaded ID card document. This workflow execute optical character recognition on the document, capturing the details like name, ID number, issue date, expiry date, etc., to name a few. Once successfully capturing data, the workflow will trigger a function to detect and capture a face from the document. So once this step is completed, the detected face will be indexed for comparison purposes using machine learning. The metadata about the data extracted and the face information will be stored in the database for transactional verification use cases. So here are the AWS services to be used for this onboarding automation task. Amazon Simple Storage Service will store the documents uploaded when a new object is uploaded in Amazon S3. Amazon Event Bridge will trigger the step function, which is the serverless orchestration service which we spoke about. The step function invokes Amazon TextStack service powered by machine learning for OCR and text extraction use cases. Amazon Recognition Service automates image and video analytics using machine learning. It is used for detecting and indexing the face provided in the identity documents. AWS Lambda is a serverless function as a service, which is then used to store the extracted information into the database or the file storages. The step function workflow is a serverless orchestration service, and you can customize the execution as per your business needs. This can be helpful for introducing any processing logic. The step function workflow receives the ID card file details once uploaded into the S3 bucket. Then the step function executes the configured workflow as discussed in the previous architecture. If any errors are encountered during this execution, an email will be triggered to the operations team. This is configured through the simple notification service subscriptions. Some examples of error cases would be a wrong document uploaded which have no face, no data, or image uploaded is blurred where no data is extracted. In such cases, the operations team will receive the details through an email. While users can be requested to upload a valid document and the workflow can be retried as well. If more than one face is detected on the document, then the facial detection API will respond with the number of faces detected, triggering an error workflow. Now let's see about Amazon TextStack. Amazon TextStack helps with the OCR and text extraction. This service is powered by deep learning neural network models, which gives it high accuracy optical character recognition outputs. It can also detect forms, tables, and other document layout characteristics. The TextStack's Analyze ID API is used to extract data from identity documents like state-issued IDs without the need of any templating or configurations. TextStack supports input formats of JPEG, PNG, TIFF, and PDF. If you have any documents in any other formats, you can convert them to any supported formats before calling TextStack service. Amazon Recognition Service is used in this solution for detecting faces in the identity document. Once a face is detected, the face information is indexed for facial analysis and comparison. So let's take a look at how to build this architecture to enable real-time transaction monitoring with the KYC information. I have created an S3 bucket to store the ID documents provided by the customers. The web application frontend should be configured to upload the ID document to this S3 bucket. I have created an AWS step function workflow to process the uploaded ID documents. Before taking a look at the step function, let's configure a rule in Amazon Event Bridge to trigger the step function whenever a new identification card is uploaded into the S3 bucket. Once reaching the Event Bridge console, click Create Rule. Let's give a name for this rule. Next, the event source should be selected as AWS Services. Scroll down and let's configure the event pattern. Select Simple Storage Service. For event type, select Amazon S3 Event Notification. I'm configuring this event to trigger the step function only for object-created events in the bucket used by the web application to store the ID cards. Specify the bucket name for the rule. Let's configure the target step function. Select the step function state machine as target, then select the state machine I have pre-created. So to recap, for the object created events on this bucket, the configured target step function will execute to process the ID cards. Click on Create Rule. Let's go to the S3 console. To upload a passport document to test the code. This is the synthetic passport document. I'm going to upload in the S3 bucket, which will be processed by the step function triggered by the Amazon Event Bridge. Let's now take a look at the step function execution. Once a step function is triggered, the AWS Lambda call the Textract Analyze ID API to gather the textual information from the identity cards. You can see the input information about the S3 file. Let's check whether the Textract OCR operation has returned any meaningful data. Textract has gathered the passport information. You can configure any validations as per your output from Amazon Textract. I'm checking whether the output detected vital information like name, type of document, document number, date of birth, issue date, etc. If the output contains these mandatory information, then the next step is to execute Amazon Recognition Detect Faces API. This machine learning powered API helps to figure out if any faces are available in the document or not. The output should contain only one detected face. Now, let's index the detected face to the Amazon Recognition. I have pre-created Amazon Recognition face collection used to store the metadata of the face detected. This face collection is used later to compare, authenticate the real-time transactions using the executor faces. So I'll walk through sample output of normal workflow execution. You can view the detailed task execution history and capture log details in case of troubleshooting, and to check your execution logic to tweak. So once the text extraction is completed and passing validation, Detect Faces API is used to check the face bounding box coordinates and trigger the face information to be indexed to the face collection. I have created a simple web application using AWS Amplify for listing the customers enrolled. Let's take a look at the recently uploaded Juan's extracted passport data. This application can be used by business teams for effectively managing and auditing the customer activities. Additionally, whenever any services that has been consumed by the users is also audited and viewable in the transactions link. Let's now take a look at an erroneous scenario. I have uploaded my picture where this document contains no identification data. In this case, Textract returns an empty response, triggering an error workflow. This is done through simple notification service. An email is triggered to the configured mail IDs about this error case. The operations team can act, or the response can be automated, where a web application can show an error message to the customer requesting them to upload a valid identification document. This is a sample email which will be received by the operations team in case of any errors. We are at the end of the KYC onboarding automation. Now let's understand how the transaction monitoring web application is built. For effectively using the face extracted from the identity document, we have built a demo web application using AWS Amplify, which is an open source full stack application development toolkit from AWS, which helps with integrating authentication, REST APIs, and web hosting. Here in this architecture, for comparing the faces during real-time transactions, the image of the customer will be captured through any camera available in the client's machine or from the customer premises and uploaded to the API for comparing using Amazon Recognition Image Analysis Machine Learning Service. This slide shows the AWS services put in use for the transaction monitoring web application architecture. With AWS Amplify, I have integrated my front-end application source code repository. On every pull request merge, I have configured Amplify to do an automated deployment, enabling end-to-end CI/CD deployment process for my front-end application. That's all about for today's session. To summarize in this session, we have set up a fully event-driven KYC automation solution which facilitates onboarding, document extraction, face registration, and face comparison. It's built in Python, but you can use any language you choose to integrate with your upstream or downstream applications and systems. The event-driven behavior is achieved using Amazon S3 Event Notification, AWS Step Functions, and Amazon Event Bridge. AWS Lambda is used to glue the end-to-end execution pipeline. Simple Notification Service is used to notify the operations team related to edge cases and error scenarios. The front-end application used for transaction monitoring is using AWS Amplify, API Gateway, AWS Lambda functions, which can help to scale efficiently based on the load, and it's cost-effective due to the serverless design of the solution. I have provided the sample implementation of this architecture in the resources. You can try it out, the solution, and customize it as per your use cases. Let's talk about the benefits of the solution. Your developers don't need ML expertise to power your workloads with biometric face validation. Instead, they can power your workload with machine learning through a bunch of APIs integrated with your web applications. No model training or management is needed. Event-driven architectures are more computationally efficient and more cost-effective. It can also be more reliable against transient issues or sudden changes in managing your needs. You can customize this architecture based on your business needs using AWS Lambda functions. This event-driven solution needs no upfront commitment, and you can pay only on the invocations you make through your application, enabling a pay-per-use costing model. You can check the links added here to explore and customize the architecture as per your organization's needs. This also contains code samples, documentation pointers of all the services shown here today. Please use the QR codes on the screen to get started. Thanks again for attending. We really appreciate your feedback to better understand the topics and services you would like to know more about. Please do take the time to fill out a survey and let us know what you think. Happy exploring and building with AWS. I hope this session is valuable to you. This is Hariharan Suresh. Thanks again. Enjoy the rest of Summit. Thank you.